Those of you who have been watching this channel for a while know that I've created 3D fashion design software tutorials for both browseware and Clo3d, with most of my more recent videos on Clo3d. But although these two are currently most used in the industry, they're not the only 3D fashion design software available. There's one that I'd heard about for quite a few years, but just hadn't had the time to use it. And that was probably a good thing because I feel like it's now on the come up. And for good reason. And now I get to experience the best of it and see it get better. That software is STYLE3D. Welcome or welcome back to my channel. My name is Nicole Drew Pelham. I talk about digital fashion design software and communication for fashion entrepreneurs on this channel. So if that's something you're interested in, make sure you subscribe and hit the notification bell. So, STYLE3D. If this is your first time hearing the name or you've heard it once or twice but don't really know much about it, you're not alone. But I think you'll be hearing a lot more about and from them in the coming months. Not only is their software comparable to others that you might be familiar with, but for those of us on a budget, it's less expensive and they do have a free option. Keep in mind that free option is limited and your rendering will be watermarked. But you can use the software. It's also overall simple to learn and use, especially if you have some previous experience using 3D fashion software. So when I try out another brand's version of a software, I like to do the same type of exercise I did with the other software so that you can really see a fair comparison, at least the first time around. So for this, I'm going to do a t-shirt with a similar style line to the one I did in my previous 3D fashion design software tutorials, so you can compare what they look like and how quickly I create them. The first thing I'm going to do is go to the resource library and add an avatar to the page. So click the 3D cube, click avatar. I'm going to double click the female folder, double click female, then leave the default settings as is once the next window appears and click OK. I normally use brown girls as my avatars, so I'm going to customize her a bit and go to the appearance folder and choose Ada. I'm also going to change her hair, and the last thing I'm going to do is put her in sneakers. Everything else I'll keep as default. I didn't change the size, but one thing you might notice right away is that the sizing options are not US-based sizing. So if you plan to use any of the default files, just keep that in mind. Of course, there is an avatar editor, so you can customize the avatar to your specifications and save those files as needed. And we'll talk about that in another video, but for now, let's keep going. In the same resource library window, go to Garment and choose the female t-shirt. Double click, keep the settings in the next window as is, then hit OK. Close that window and then hit the space bar to simulate the T on the avatar. One other thing I am going to do, and this is purely because it's what I'm used to seeing, I'm going to switch the 2D and the 3D windows, and you can do this by clicking the double arrow icon in the upper right corner of either window, and then drag the window to the opposite side until you see the blue highlight. Then let go of your mouse so it can snap into place. Okay, let's create the asymmetrical style line on the front body. And what's cool about STYLE3D for my Illustrator users is that there's a pen tool that works just like the pen tool in Illustrator, so you can draw your style line just like you do it if you were drawing it on your flat sketch. Like the T I previously created, this front view is symmetrically linked. So if I just start drawing, it's not going to make an asymmetrical style line. So I first need to remove the linked editing, which I'll do by right mouse clicking and choosing remove linked editing. And then I can use the pen and draw my style line. If I need to edit the style line, I'll use the edit curve tool, which kind of acts like the white arrow in Illustrator to select and move a point or select a line to bring up handles that work exactly like direction handles to reshape the curve. Now I'll go back to the select move tool and select the style line so I can cut and sew it. Before I do that, I want to make sure that my new style line is actually touching the edges of the T body so that it'll cut and sew the pattern piece properly. So first, select the style line, right mouse click and choose extend trim to outline. Now, right mouse click again and choose cut and sew. Simulate if necessary, and then let's quickly add some color. Navigate to the fabric icon and double click the default fabric. Mine happens to have a second fabric, so I'll click that, which will open the property editor. And in the texture area, click the white rectangle next to color, choose a color from the window that appears, and then click OK. To add a different color to the bottom of the T, I need to create another fabric, even if it's the same fabric, so I can give it a different color. So I'm going to just click the plus to add another fabric, choose a different color, select the pattern I want in the new color, and then right mouse click over the fabric and select assign to pattern. Done. I may have completed that quicker than the T in my Clo video, even with the extra commentary. In defense of that video, I was just starting. I've got a good 2+ years using 3D under my belt now, so a T should be very simple. So, my overall thoughts. I like it. It's simple, easy to use. This was obviously a simple style, but I really didn't have any issues completing it. Any small things that I feel like might be tripping me up are most likely attributed to having used other software and just getting used to their shortcuts or where things are in that software, not because it's truly a problem in STYLE3D. I think what I like most so far is the pen tool because it works so much like Illustrator's pen tool, and the edit curve tool because it's like the white arrow, and that the select move tool is named exactly what it is in Illustrator and Photoshop. There are similar tools in other programs that look and work the same way, but they're named something else. Naming it select move, I mean, it's obvious what it does, but I also think it's beneficial that it's the same name as Adobe, since a lot of designers who would be using this software would have used those programs, and it just helps to associate the two. I also have to say, I'm actually happy that there are tools that feel familiar because it just lowers the learning curve and allows a designer to use the program and start having fun with it that much more quickly. So far, I kind of like STYLE3D, and I'm excited to start creating some other things. I hope that all of you will try it out too, and let me know in the comments what you think. Thanks for watching today's video. Stay tuned for more STYLE3D tutorials in the coming months. And in the meantime, check out some of my other 3D fashion design software tutorials on this channel. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe, and share this video if you find it helpful. Have a fantastic week, and I'll see you next time.